I was really impressed by the guy that spent, oh, it was the guy that got engaged, not that talker, that spent like 10 minutes unwinding this. I thought that was really cool. If Eric's here, I feel really bad because I couldn't remember the name of the class that I just finished taking with him. She's like, you know, Eric's class. I'm like, woo! And I tried to give the general woo and it didn't really work. So anyway, my story's about traveling overseas, and something that I try to do when I travel overseas is fit in. And the way I try to fit in is through total cultural immersion. Usually what that means is living with local families. And when I live with local families, so that's, you know, you guys aren't cooking yet, it's cultural immersion, whatever. But when I live with local families, I try to go serious cultural immersion. So anyway, what that means is doing everything that they do like they do it. And that starts with eating. So every single thing that they eat, I eat. And I learned to just say yes. It's sort of like the dude, Shane. I just say yes, I'll take it. But there's a problem with that. If you say yes and you get cultural immersion from eating, that means you also get cultural immersion in the bathroom. This is what you're waiting for. So, cultural immersion in the bathroom. I try to immerse myself, let me just put it this way. My theory is sort of like, when in Rome, poop, that was the Romans poop. And so I was going through a tough time. My dad was sick, went to the hospital down the street, good place. And my love life was falling apart, I hated my job. I said, I've got to get as far away as possible. So I went to this place called the Solomon Islands, really far away. Apparently there are like 900 islands and about 2,000 tourists a year, right? So that means like 2.2 tourists per island, something like that. And anyway, I signed up for what's called a village stay. And so I get there and it was beautiful, like towering palm trees bending in toward the sand, you know, the smell of the water rising up, wafting into my nose. This is amazing. I say, I've got to fit in. I've got to do cultural immersion. So I say, where do I poop? And I look around and I see that I actually have my own dedicated outhouse attached to the little hut that they put in. And I walk into the outhouse. I'm like, okay, I'm going to poop the way the locals poop. And I walk into the outhouse and it's just a toilet. It looks exactly like the toilet at World Cafe Live. I'm serious. It's like the sort of standard porcelain thing, the one that the people smoking weed were like hugging, and it's just like there on the sand with a pit over it, with a pit under it, and I'm saying, gosh, I'm not getting cultural immersion here. They're not, this is not how they do it. So I say, at least I'm going to fit in by taking a shower. So the same way they do it. So there's a village tap. Get up the next morning, and I start walking toward the village tap. And what I notice is that the village tap has no protective screens. I have to go into the village tap alone and take a shower in front of the entire village. And as I'm walking out of my little hut, I'm like, okay, well, let's keep my shorts and my t-shirt on. And I just finished the run. I was like that guy, that gringo. You know how everywhere you go, there's like, you know, you see someone running in a country that's like hot, and it's always the American. So people are like, we actually like get exercise by, you know, fishing or by catching possums in the woods there. But no, I had to go for a run that morning, so I'm all sweaty. And anyway, so I'm there, and I'm in my shorts and my t-shirt. Well, this village elder is there in his towel, and he walks out just as I walk out. It's sort of like when you're like, you need the shower, you're sharing a bathroom with your roommate, and like, you both walk out at the same time, and you're like, oh shit, who gets it? Who's going to get to work late? Who's not going to get to work late? So anyway, that was me. And anyway, I'm like, go ahead. He says, no, you go ahead. I said, no, you go ahead. He goes, no, you go ahead. So I'm like, okay, I'll go ahead. So I walk in to the village shower, and I undress. And I'm standing there completely naked in a village of about 100 people in the South Pacific, and I start showering. And all of a sudden, people start running up with these like tarps and canvases, and they start throwing them around me like that woman who took her shirt off at the tennis match, and they were holding the towels in front of her, and people are like this, and like this, and like this. And I'm like, what's going on? I'm doing cultural murder. And then I finish showering, and I don't know what's going on, and I go back, and I put my clothes on. And the village elder, who had been just in his towel, the one who was inspired me to do this whole thing, walks out, gets into the shower, drops his towel, and he's wearing a bathing suit. And so I have become the first naked showerer. Me, one out of the 2.2 tourists on that island, showered naked in front of a village of 100 people. And so I said, I'm not going to make that same mistake tomorrow. And so I got up, and I said, I'm not going to go for a run. I'm not going to get so sweaty. I'm going to go for a swim like the villagers swim. And so I jump in the water, and I swim back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. And finally, I get out of the water, and the guy that was hosting me had this beautiful, beautiful Solomon Islands pigeon. And he says, Mike, that follow water there, that follow water is where we follow villagers. Go for number two. And I said, that is cultural immersion. But I think I did the right thing. Because they do this thing there called storying. It's actually a verb. And I guarantee they're laughing harder at me over there right now than you guys are laughing at me right now. Thank you.